When I started to make a living as a music producer, I always made an effort to explain to my peers how I achieved it. Some of the most talented music composers I talked to never got on board. Want to know the reason why?
DelicateBeats.com.
They wanted to wait until their song demos were perfect. Today, I'd like to have a discussion with you around perfectionism and how this habit of waiting for your creations to be perfect is hurting, stalling, or even destroying your career. So here are five ways perfectionists hinder their career in music. Number one, you think you always need more stuff. I come from the analog era. Back in those days, every producer thought they would only make it once they'd get their hands on expensive outboard gear or fancy SSL consoles. Fortunately, the laptop producer era has proved this is just a bunch of hogwash. But producers still find a way to hide their insecurities behind other areas of music production. New plugins, new presets, new sound design techniques, new mixing techniques, better mastering techniques. You get the idea. I'm on a bunch of Facebook pages for producers, and a lot of people talk about these incredibly complex production techniques. They forget that at the end of the day, none of that will guarantee you a hit song. I gotta say it, it's intellectual masturbation. There's always going to be something to improve upon. That's what makes music such an incredible personal quest. Number two, you don't share enough. In the age of content marketing, it's all about building momentum. If you want to be relevant, you have to stay in front of your audience. The best way to tell if your song sucks or is actually pretty good is to use your audience as a sounding board. No pun intended. Release often. Let the public judge your work. It becomes so much easier to have an informed opinion on your work once it's out there. The same happens to me once I commit to getting a song mastered. Only then can I really hear if my mix was good or not. It's quite surprising how committing yourself to getting your song out of your computer answers all your questions. Number three, fearing the consequences. What's the worst that can happen if you release a song and it bombs? Lately, I released a track with an artist and, well, it didn't get millions of streams. Ah well. You know what I realized? The track is great and has insane replay value. So I ask you this. Would you rather release a song that blows up, but that in the back of your head, you know is far from being your best work? I know I wouldn't. I'm ultra proud of the release I just talked to you about. I think it's great music. And for the people who know me, that never happens. I'm closing on 40 years of age and still haven't released an EP to my name yet. Now that's embarrassing. Number four, success has become a distorted concept. Mainstream media loves a good child prodigy story. As musicians, we see all these teens getting famous seemingly overnight. And what do? We compare ourselves to them. Is it too late for me? Am I too old to make it? What's wrong with me? Why are kids passing me in the fast lane? So my point is, age is a wrong metric. The other wrong metric is clout. Let's go back to the release I talked to you about. When the song was finished and ready to be released, we had two choices. Release it with a big label, get a little money up front, the potential to get more streams, but with a tiny percentage of the royalties. And then we could release it with a small label, get no money up front, the potential for less streams, but a way bigger percentage of the royalties. At the end of the day, I did the math and no option would have made us more cash. So I ask you this, what do you judge success on? Money? Fame? Listen, there's no right or wrong answer. Pick a metric for success and judge your success based on that metric. Number five, train your decision muscle. Comfort gets you nowhere fast. One of your greatest strengths is your ability to make difficult choices and keep it moving. The more you do it, the easier it becomes. Overcome the first four points I talked about using your decision muscle. Look at where you are in 1 year. I promise you'll be amazed at your accomplishments. So to close this video, I just want to invite us to see our quest for perfection for what it is, fear. We all have it. The difference between people who are and people who could have been is their ability to live with their fear. It's not going away, but it doesn't have to stop you from creating cool things. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you did, share it on social media, subscribe to my channel, and also follow me on Instagram at delicatebeats. I'm preparing something for my producer family, and I don't want you to miss out.